Hi there, welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I want to show you how you can break a Google Sheet into separate pages for printing. So have you ever had this happen when you go and hit print like this, and it just is a long document, so it's really small? Well, I want to show you how you can go from this and turn it into separate pages where it's much easier to read. I got two different examples to show you how this will work really well in Google Sheets. So here's the first example, and I already showed you a bit of this in the intro, but if I go to hit print here, this becomes really small here to fit everything on a page, and especially if I want it on portrait. What you need to do is turn on the custom page breaks right here. So if I go ahead and click this on, notice it changed automatically. If I go through, it's separated into different pages. I don't have the months on every page. I'm going to show you how to do that in a moment. But if I go here and just click edit, I can see how already this is broken in. So wherever these lines are right here, I could choose even to break this into smaller. So I can click and drag these over. So maybe if I wanted one here, I can keep bringing them over, just broken into chunks like this. And even if I drag over from the side, notice I can keep having more appear and I can keep going from the side just like that. So that's a little bit random and it's not really broken up well. But just to show you, if I hit confirm, everything's broken up on how I did it there. Now, if I go back and hit edit, I can delete these too. So if you just hover over, you can delete these and then maybe you want to set it up a little bit differently, not so crazy as all the different ones that I put in last time. Now, the other thing I want to show you is that if I go back here, notice that this didn't have the months on every page and that can make it hard to read. If I go back and I'm just going to hit cancel, I'm going to freeze the first row. So I want to see the months on every page. I'm just going to go here and drop down and go to the bottom and freeze column A. What that does, if I go to print now, notice, and I'll zoom up here, if I go down, they're on every one, because if I just click and expand this, notice at the very bottom it says repeat frozen columns. So I can turn this off if I don't want, but then I can also do this with rows as well. So if I was going to more of the vertical, I could turn that on and it would be on every page. So if you're handing something out, it just makes it a lot easier to read. Now I could go at this point and just hit next, and I can choose to print to a printer, or maybe I just want these as PDFs right now and it's going to separate it into those different pages. Here's example number two, and I'll put a link to this Google Sheet down below so you can just click on it and create a copy of it. Follow along as I go along. I have four different quadrants here. You can see 20, 21, 20, 20, 19, and 18 of different revenue. I'm going to go ahead and just hit print. Right away, this will not print very well, how it's putting things on different pages. So I want to break it down by on each page to have the different year revenue. So I'm going to go and set my page breaks here. And the first thing, I'm going to take this one here. And the one thing I'd say is if you, sometimes it's good to insert extra columns in the middle to even things out when you're printing or on the sides, just to make it more balanced on the sheet. The other way I want to split it is right here. So I'm going to bring this back. Notice I kind of have an equal between each of these where I can easily put these page breaks into. If it is where you want, go ahead and hit confirm. And you can see how it looks from there. If you don't want the grid lines, remember that's under formatting, you can turn that off. The other thing I want to point out is depending on how you want things printed. So in this case, is it over then down, or is it down then over? So I'm going over then down. So just make sure you have that and we can do some alignment with center or top, depending where you want it. So if you wanted it more at the left or right into the center, we can change all these things on it. So that's a little tip on how to print your documents in Google Sheets, how to separate them by pages using the page break so you can make things a lot cleaner when you print, just for yourself and if you're sharing with other people. I hope you like this tip today on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.